Alex.
Hey, how's it going? I've enjoyed learning about stem cells since I was in high school, and I always thought they were super cool and I wanted to do that.
I decided to do the project in an underserved area in Richmond.
In 2007, I traveled to Pakistan. First time in my life seeing these children begging for money and food on the streets. So that's what really got me into trying to help the developing world.
My research is basically to revive this dyeing embroidery techniques in Qinghai, China.
Not only that they were underserved in a social aspect, but also very much, like you said, in kind of a healthcare aspect.
My project was focused on the impact of migration, but not once people get here to the United States, but more focused on the people that are left behind in an indigenous village that I traveled to this summer in Mexico.
My project's about taking the silk from silk moth cocoons and incorporating them into a structure that you can grow stem cells on.
So my project was developing information communication technology for education in Haiti.
You worked a lot with like oral hygiene techniques, things such as simply as brushing and flossing,
right.
And then with the nutritional side of things, you know, talking about, you know, healthy eating options.
It's like the aha moment for me. It's like, oh my God, what if I bring more people into this project? It's going to have bigger voices with more artists.
I felt really fulfilled and proud that people were able to open up to me and feel comfortable sharing really intimate stories of migration, people who have literally physically by foot crossed the border.
The biggest one was when we were giving a presentation and someone asked actually what floss was.
Yes. Like the thing you always get in your goodie bag, like, right. You know, floss.
But that like rewarding moment that we knew we were in the right spot at the right time.
And just kind of sitting in the lab and being like, oh my God, I'm finally working with these things I've been dreaming of. It's like, that's what motivates me.
When I saw their faces light up, that was probably the best part of the whole trip. And then actually seeing my research being implemented and helping these students and teachers out, it was kind of a moment, it was kind of surreal.
When I go to report sessions in Qinghai back to the tribe, like how excited people were.
I guess bringing back and showing them like, look what I made.
Yeah, right. Like what I made, what we made.
Honestly, the relationships we built with the individuals in that community was really rewarding.
I also think that, you know, people wanting to give me things that they've crafted after talking to them, me taking from them and taking this information, but then also still wanting to give more was really amazing.
It was really awesome.